Interesting. Stop everything else and study it.
That's it. Welcome to the Daily BA. We're on the Norway series and we're digging through some boxes that my good friend Dag that we talked about yesterday, his father had. So check this out.
It smells.
It's like 40 years old.
It says Skinner.
Yes. I found it today and I haven't been looking at it. Maybe in 20 years. A letter from Skinner.
You smashed his finger in a door.
Yeah. I nearly killed him.
I simply felt sorry for you.
The finger is healed perfectly and never bothered me at any time.
Yeah. You see, he was a very decent person.
Are you the baby tender baby?
No, it's my brother.
Yes, his brother. Why don't you bring them to see us when you come to America? What?
Thanks a lot.
I can't remember everything. This is the most interesting letter. I have the original too, someplace.
Dear Dr. Carlson, thanks very much for the pictures which I have posted in my office. I was delighted to learn that your child is being raised in a box.
In a box? Really?
Yes. Yeah. As you may know, the newspapers called me about it, though I have not seen nor could I read the articles. You're not the first to ask about the Big Bang sentence. Power certainly is a bad concept. I'm not sure, however, that nature should be converted into an originating agent. And belated greetings from the season to you and my other friends in Norway. Cordially, Fred Skinner. Skinner isn't the end-all be-all of our field, but it's pretty damn cool to see these things. My students have a rock and roll band called Skinnerheads.
Yes!
On their chests. The selected ones. Is this real?
It's real. My students.
Like tattooed?
T-shirts.
Yes. Oh, yes. I think
they got a tattoo.
That's
awesome.
Hardcore.
Yeah.
If anyone wants to start that, I am totally in. I play guitar. We'll commit to tattoos, though. No shirts. Shane Spiker, I'm looking at you.
Oh, yes, this. But for both theoretical and practical purposes, it is important to remember that we are always dealing with positive probabilities. Punishment, as we have seen, does not create a negative probability that the response will be made, but rather a positive probability that incompatible behavior will occur.
Mm-hmm.
And my resistance behavior is incompatible behavior. When we are aggressive, we are saying, also the feeling of aggression.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm afraid of you.
Yeah.
And I'm hitting you.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it's very reinforcing behavior. But if you are a very, very dangerous person, I should like to hit you. But of course, you have a gun.
Uh-huh.
I'm doing like this. I have some resistance behavior because if I don't resist,
mm-hmm.
you will shoot me. So it means my behavior is controlled by negative reinforcement.
Yeah.
Not by punishment, because
yep.
if I'm hitting you and you're shooting me, I will be punished.
And that's why you have that increased
yeah.
probability
yeah.
of the incompatible response.
That's right.
Yeah.
So therefore, most people, they don't, and my students, they didn't understand the concept of negative reinforcement and positive punishment. When I talked to him about my resistance training,
mm-hmm.
he was listening carefully and he said, Arild, I think you've got something here. I think you got something. So therefore, this, when you run into, onto something interesting, drop everything else and study it.
So let me know what you think about this resistance behavior and maybe this potentially large misconception between punishment and negative reinforcement. I don't know. I'm gonna leave the question off to you. Comment down below if this conceptualization is even useful for you. I will see you tomorrow where we talk with Brittany DeSanti. She's a PhD student over at Oslo Met in Oslo, Norway.
Let's start with the story. Everyone's got a story how they got into the field. So okay. What's yours?
I like this one.
Yeah.
That one's pretty easy.
And that's your Daily BA. Oh, like, share, subscribe. Don't forget. Come on, hook a brother up. Peace.